Welcome back from that break. We're still discussing and looking at mental health, but most importantly, depression. We're glad you joined us from wherever you are. My name is Lynn. I have with me Will Broad. I have Gloria Ketch, and I have Dr. Moses. We're trying to discuss depression. Somebody in your house is depressed. We all get depressed at some point, but then the doctor says there is something. Doctor, tell us.
Each of us gets depressed at one point. But now, the severity of the problem is what varies. We are considering depression as a condition which is having levels. There is a mild, there is moderate, and there is severe. Most of the people who are having mild depression are never diagnosed. And they are with us in the community. They are mistaken for irritable people. They are mistaken for very strict people. They are mistaken for lazy people, people who don't mind, who people who are inconsiderate, people who are lonely, who choose to be loners, like that. But then we have another level, which is mild. Now, mild depression, at that point, the person now starts having a behavior that starts conflicting with the society. And when this behavior starts conflicting with society, that's when people start realizing, oh, somebody is not acting as he's expected to be. And when that person is not behaving like he's expected to be, then people, there are two things. People might either agree to be to live with you like that, or even try to correct you otherwise. But the way they do it, of course, is not professional, and it leads to conflict. And when it leads to conflict, that's when you get somebody now being considered like is having outblown.
At what point do you realize now this is a psychiatric either emergency or problem?
Now, usually, people who suffer, by the way, depression is the commonest mental disorder.
In
the
world,
if you get a paper written on common mental illness, they are referring to depression, actually. Because all of us get depressed at one point. But the severity is what matters, and the extent to which the condition is really affecting your daily life is what matters. Otherwise, all of us are suffering, and the point at which somebody is considered as ill is according to one's way of perception. Now, I may be perceived by my close associates as depressed according to the way they see me. For example, there are so many triggers, as she said. Somebody can lose a pen or a lid of a pen. Just losing a lid of a pen, and that one will become hell. He will even remember that point when he lost that lead even after 2 weeks. Oh, I lost my lead here. And then somebody loses a phone. And he's like, I wish I couldn't recover my numbers that got lost within the phone. Now, these are people responding to two different things. One which is looking more severe than the other one, but the other one is able to cope up. Now, that means that the person's body, the way the body is responding to a situation, is different. Now, you may find a person who is having this condition, depression, as we said earlier, is lacking the neurotransmitters. And the neurotransmitters, namely serotonin and then noradrenaline, norepinephrine. Those ones are low in the body. And when they are low in the body, this person is unable to have that mental energy to cope. Is unable to have that physical energy to cope. And now, he may not want even any interference. You know, anything that looks like is interfering with the well-being looks as if it is so huge. It is actually amplified. Have you ever run and you are about to reach the finishing point, and then people are saying, run, but you cannot go? Now, similarly, these people are trying to stretch, but they cannot reach there because the body, the makeup of the body at that point cannot really go that far. So the mental energy and the physical energy is really so reduced. A person may see, you know, it can be compared with a wall. You know, when I was young, I used to see my grandfather's house as the tallest house in the world because I could not even touch the window. Yeah? But when I grew up, I was wondering what happened to the house because it looked so small, smaller than the rest of the houses. Now, this is exactly what happens to these people. Something appears small, but it is really a huge problem. And it is triggering even a thinking that life is not worth living. Now, this is when the person really needs support. You can imagine when you go to a banana plantation and you have a big banana, you may never carry that banana for even 2 meters. It is so heavy. But then when you get somebody to help you put it on the head, you can even go 2 kilometers. Now, this kind of support is required for these people. It is because it's not tangible, it's not seen, but people really need this kind of support. They need to be initiated into managing a problem. And problems that are triggering the attacks, as she's saying, to other people, they look so minor. And somebody may think, just because somebody has borrowed your pen and lost a lid, do you need to break glasses? Do you need to hit with him with a kettle of boiling water? And somebody is looking at that as something minor. Do you know how the person is feeling? The feeling within that person is so bad that, you know, it is like you are the worst person ever. So we need to look at people with depression with a lot of consideration. They are not viewing the same thing in the same way and the same perception. You may, and that's why I usually tell people, never quarrel with strangers. You don't know how the person is feeling like. You don't know how the person's body is functioning like. And then you start tuning yourself to the tune of somebody who is perceiving things differently. And then you end up like the person is bad as they are considered to be bad. So, what are we saying now? Depression is a common disease, is a common condition. All of us suffer from it. And the symptoms vary from excessive sadness. Now, when it becomes excessive, that's when people are diagnosed. This person may not even have...
People shut out. There's that point where they shut out.
They shut out. And that shutting out is when these neurotransmitters are extremely very low. Very low to the extent that the person may not even be able to wake up. And again, the biggest problem they suffer is lack of sleep. And this is at a point when I want to tell the public, whenever you have a condition that is robbing you of sleep, go and see somebody for help. People think that lack of sleep is... People, by the way, praise themselves. They say, with me, when at night something knocking out, but I'm already aware.
I used to be like that.
And I'm a great person. With me, I'm very okay. Please, you are bad love.
I actually used to brag about it.
Don't brag about it. All diseases...
Not anymore. Now I'm okay.
Conditions, all mental conditions, the first thing they do is to rob you of sleep. They rob you of sleep, then terrorize you when you have open eyes.
Let me ask Kaket here. At what point did you realize that, you see, I think I need help?
He was talking about, I'm laughing. Like I said, I don't show emotion, but I'm really dying of laughter inside. Talking about sleep, I literally don't sleep. I sleep, if I'm to put my head down, it's 4 a.m. every day, from Monday to Monday. And the only way I can actually shut off, a TV must be on, a radio must be on. In a quiet place, like completely quiet, there is no way. I'm either dreaming, tossing and turning, I am hot. It's either a fan, at least put a fan that will bring sleep to me. So, but those are coping mechanisms, because before I just go 2 days without nothing, I don't take coffee, But then how do you cope? Because you're awake, you get busy, so you open the fridge, get a whiskey, and then you keep, you know, before you know it's morning, and then you have to do some stuff then. So I had to learn, because I was me, I don't believe in medication. I had to learn not to do the sleeping pills. So I tried that. I realized every time I'm watching a movie, I actually doze off somewhere. So my therapist like, let's try the TV thing. So just leave it on and just stand the other side. And before you know, it's morning. So it works for me. Quiet place, oh, believe you me, I will be hearing the cockroaches and everything he's talking about. So how did I know that I need help now? I started walking out of people's lives without explanation. Because every time I explain to you and I explain again and then again, you start
getting to you.
I get anger of, don't you just understand me, or I'm just not making sense to you? So I always chose to walk away. I walked away from my first marriage, walked away from my second one without the proper... I'm like, we're just not clicking. Is this something we cannot work around? And every time, like, my family would say, let's sit down, families, and I would ask them, for what? You have this zeal of, I can't do that. Because to me, it was taking me in an area I don't want to go to. An area where you start shouting. An area where I'm like, those are no-go areas for me. I jumped out of a speeding car. See, I have this car. I have, I have one on my head. It's just that we have hair.
We
have hair, we also buy. So we just...
Was that bad?
It was going over 100 kilometers per hour. And I'm in the car with somebody and it's not a disagreement. I was insisting I wanted to go somewhere else. But it's late. If you have to go home, I'm like, it's late. It's just 11 p.m. I want to go elsewhere. No. I think we should go home. So yeah, I'm like, oh. So you're literally just not going to do what I want. So I just opened the door. I tried the first time. He grabbed my hand. What are you doing? So increasing speed, he thought was going to scare me. Now, little did he know, that is a trigger point for me. You're trying to show me I can't. So now let me also show you that I can. It's that crazy.
Wow. I'm sorry, Akash. I need to cut you short. We need to take a break. She jumped out of a speeding car. My God. Have you noticed? Do you really look at your friends? Do you see what they're going through? Do you pay attention? We'll be right back.